Lydia. Good morning, everyone, and Merry Christmas. Welcome to this year's Lower School Christmas program. You are in for a special treat. Mrs. Blatz is always so wonderful about giving me a surprise each year. This year's program's different than any other one, just like we always have. This year, we actually sent our actors and actresses down to Miami to the Museum of Trains because we are on the Christmas Express. So they filmed right from a real train. So that's what you're going to see as the program progresses. So a couple of housekeeping things before we get started. Please check your phone. Make sure it's on silent. Also, after the program, you are welcome to go across the street and pick up your child from the classroom. Please make sure you have a wristband. That will get you past security and you won't have to stand in a long line. That's your fast pass to your child for the Christmas break. So we are excited. I saw the dress rehearsal just the other day. This is a fabulous, high energy, fun program that you are gonna enjoy. So sit back, relax. We're videotaping so you don't have to. So we're gonna enjoy the program. We're gonna open up with Mr. Satterley and then the kids will take over from there.
Well, good morning and Merry Christmas. This is always a wonderful way to conclude this first semester and to wrap up with our lower school children teaching us about Christmas. Christmas always can have a different feel depending upon your season of life. A couple nights ago, I was out in my garage putting together a little radio flyer wagon. Now, it's one of those things, you know, if you've done this before, the instructions usually are written in a way to confuse you. I think, you know, it's part of it intentionally. But my frustration level was exceedingly lower this time than the last time I put something together like that, because it wasn't for one of my children, it's for my grandson. And, you know, it's amazing how quickly your frustration level changes when you have that seasons of life for Christmas. I wanted to tell a brief Christmas story this morning as we begin our time together about the power of children to teach us about what Christmas really represents. I would love to tell you this was my story. I heard this story for the first time when I was some of these students' age behind me. The story goes something like this. There was a country church, and every year they did a Christmas pageant. And they always would include the children. And there was this one family that kind of lived on the far edge of town that was socially awkward. They didn't quite fit, and they had one little boy named Johnny. And Johnny, he was always kind of hard to include him and how to figure out, and he didn't quite say the right things. But it was a small church, and everybody needed to have a role. So they put the adults came together and said, how do we include everybody? And so they had found a role for Johnny. Here's the role Johnny got, the innkeeper. They made Johnny the innkeeper and said, you know, all he has to do is open the door and say no and slam the door. That'll be perfect for him. They sat him down and said, Johnny, open the door when they knock, yell no, and slam the door. Opening night comes. Pageant's going through. Mary and Joseph make their way to the inn. They knock on the door. Johnny opens the door, says no, slams it. Mary and Joseph, the adults all give a sigh of relief. Mary and Joseph move on. Just as they clear that part of the set, the door flies open and there's Johnny, who says, Mary, Joseph, come back. Come back. You can have my room. The baby Jesus can't be born in a manger. Come inside. You can have all that I have, you can have. Come to my room. Such is the story of Christmas. Little children sometimes are the best teachers for us. Johnny taught that church that Christmas truly about what that majesty and celebration and how incredible the gift of Jesus is for us. He taught them that in the ways that the rest of the adults could not. So as we enjoy our youngest students today who are going to teach us through song and through what they present to us, let's be reminded about that greatest gift and the true meaning of Christmas that we have. Let me pray for us. Heavenly Father, thanks we can gather in this place. Thank you that we can be part of a community where we can celebrate this gift. Thank you that we can recognize what this is. God, we pray for our students as they present to us, that their time of preparation would be honored and that you would be glorified in the use of their gifts. Father, we pray that as we enjoy this, that we would turn our eyes toward Jesus, the greatest gift the world has ever had. And in his name we pray, amen.
Thank you.
Hey, give me back the remote.
You know, you should say, please give me back the remote.
Okay, please, give me back the remote.
Nope, it's my turn to pick the station.
Wait, you just said that if I had said please, you'd give me back the remote.
Correction, I only said that you should say please. I'd never say I'd give it to you.
You're mean, I'm telling Mom. Mom, Jeremy won't give me back the remote.
Fine, here, take it. Just put something good on. Good idea. You do it. And I'll watch Frosty's Big Extravaganza 2020.
No, it's both our jobs. Maybe something on TV will inspire us. And I doubt it will be Frosty's Big Extravaganza 2020. Hey, look. The Christmas Express?
Oh, friend to the Christmas Express. You are in the joy car, and indeed a joy to have you with us today. Our final destination is Bethlehem, Pennsylvania, the most wonderful place to spend Christmas Eve.
Hello, I heard your name is Jenny. I'm Miss Davis, and you look cool. Would you like my jacket?
Actually, I love it. Thank you.
Are you going all the way to Bethlehem, Jenny?
Yes, I work there. And at least I work there until tomorrow. I'm a waitress, and the diner I work at is closing. Tonight will be our last night.
That's awful! And it's on Christmas Eve!
Who are all the gifts for, Jenny?
Max! Sorry, Max asks a lot of questions.
Oh, it's okay. These gifts are for some very special people I met at the diner. They become my friends, and I'm going to miss seeing them.
Maybe you all can come to our cabin tonight. Our choir is singing.
And we're in the nativity.
I'd love to, but I have to work. But I really do like your costume.
Thanks. Abby, Abe, and I are all shepherds.
I'm a shepherdess. Girls can be shepherds, too.
That's right, Ava. I remember the one Christmas I got to be in the nativity scene.
Were you a shepherdess, too?
No, I was an angel. That night, I had such bad stage fright that I didn't even remember anything except the one line I had.
What was it?
Fear not.
We had an angel, but she got the flu.
Yes. Actually, quite a few of our major scene characters caught the flu.
Mrs. Davis, I have an idea.
Well, Abby, I think that's a great idea. Why don't you ask her?
Jenny, would you like to hear us sing a song?
A song?
It's a song about angels. It might help you remember. Do you want to hear it?
Yes, I'd love to hear it.
Are we slowing down? Are we already there?
Hello, everyone. I just wanted to let you know
that we are making a quick stop to pick up a passenger. Then we'll continue our journey.
Wait, we're stopping for one passenger?
It must be a very important person.
Yes, yes, I know about the weather, but I've got to take care of this important real estate deal. I don't care if it's Christmas Eve. This is more important. Listen, I have to go. Where's the conductor?
I'm right here, sir. How may I help you?
Well, there's obviously been a mistake. I can't be in this car.
Let me see your ticket, sir. No, you're in the right car, right where you belong.
Well, this car is full of... Well, it's full. You need to move me to another car immediately.
I'm sorry, sir, but there are no more seats.
Do you know who I am? I am Theodore Higginsworth III. My company could buy this train.
Maybe, sir, but tonight you're just fortunate to get a seat.
You can sit here, mister, next to me.
Great. Just great. Just great.
Okay, everyone. Next stop, Bethlehem, Pennsylvania.
Yay! Yay!
What are you looking at?
Nothing. That's my sister, Ava.
One.
And I'm Max. We're going to the pageant in Bethlehem. Are you going to the pageant?
Max.
The what?
The Christmas pageant. Are you going?
Max.
No, no, no. I'm not going to the pageant.
Oh, Max, now you've done it.
I'm going to Bethlehem for important business. Believe me, if it wasn't such important business, I would not be on this train, in this car, with a bunch of kids in bathrobes.
This isn't my bathrobe. It's my costume. I'm in the nativity.
How nice.
Mister, we're going to Bethlehem to celebrate Jesus' birthday.
I'm sorry, whose birthday?
Jesus! Christmas is Jesus' birthday!
my. What beautiful sound you're coming from this car. One can hear singing all the way from the engine to the caboose. And how are we doing, Mr. Hagenworth?
Terrible. I can't even think. It's so noisy. Isn't there something you can do to keep them quiet?
I don't think so.
Not on Christmas Eve.
Excuse me, sir. Have you always been the conductor on the Christmas Express?
Yes, as long as I can remember. We've been making this journey every Christmas Eve for many, many years.
Will you be going to the pageant tonight?
I wouldn't miss it for the world. I look forward to the singing and the celebration. You know, Christmas doesn't mean Christmas without Christmas songs.
I agree. It's time for rejoicing. In fact, the greatest night of praise the earth ever knew may have happened on this very first Christmas.
That was the night Jesus was born. Oh, wait a minute. That was in Bethlehem, too.
Yes, a long time ago.
On that night, a multitude of angels filled the sky announcing the birth of God's son with their praise.
What's a multitude?
A lot, like a zillion.
What's that, Mr. Hagenworth?
I said you don't actually believe that story, do you?
What story are you referring to, Mr. Hagenworth?
The one you're talking about, the angels, that baby.
Yes, we do.
We believe every single word. That baby was Jesus.
And those angels were real.
And just like those angels, we're going to praise him. Why, we wouldn't want those rocks to cry out now, would we?
What? simply have to get out of his car. There's just too much noise.
I'm sorry, sir, but as I said before, you're right where you're supposed to be, in the toy car. Try to enjoy the journey. And look, here comes the hot chocolate now.
Christmas Eve. It's a very special night, and I'm going to miss it.
Special? If my company ran their business that way, we'd be going out of business. And whoever started this whole gift-giving thing anyway?
God did. Jesus was God's gift to us.
There you go again with the Christmas fairy tale.
Christmas isn't a fairy tale. Mr. Higginsworth, God can bring people so much joy. Maybe you should try it.
Yeah, remember, you're in the joy car. I'm in the joy car. Maybe you should sing Mr. Higginsworth a song about joy.
Yeah!
Oh no, here we go again with the singing.
We'll be right back.
this straight. Do you people actually believe in enjoying life by putting others first? There is no way to get ahead. I need to get some air.
Mrs. Davis, why do you think Mr. Higginsworth hates Christmas?
I don't think he hates it. He just doesn't believe it ever happened.
Well, he sure doesn't like giving presents.
Maybe no one ever gave him a present.
Maybe no one ever told him about Jesus.
Maybe we should tell him.
I don't think he would listen.
I don't think it's an accident he's in this car with us. I believe God has something very special planned for Mr. Higginsworth.
Miss Davis, do you believe that God has a plan for everyone?
Yes. Yes, I do.
I wonder if he can help me.
Yes, he can, because he loves you.
I know it's hard sometimes, but he knows what's called, and he will always be there for you.
It's just that after tonight, I won't have a job, and I worry about my friends. I guess we all need a Christmas miracle.
Jenny, don't you know that nothing is impossible with God?
Look outside! It's snowing!
It's snowing!
Attention! Hello, everyone. There's no reason for alarm, but we need to make a quick stop. We've got a situation to take care of. So sit back and relax, maybe sing a few songs. And there's our friend, Mr. Higginsworth.
Can anyone tell me why this train is stopping?
No worries. I'm sure we'll be on the way in a few minutes.
Can my day get any worse?
Oh, can I come inside this train car? It's cold out there.
Do you have a ticket?
No.
Well, as you can see, this car is full.
Come on,
Mr. Higginsworth.
Here, you look cold. Take this cup.
Thank you. I was hitching a ride in the open car when it suddenly started snowing. It's a miracle this train stopped.
This is just great. It's Christmas Eve and I'm stuck with a bunch of kids and a homeless person.
Wait a minute, I know you.
You do?
Yeah, you're the waitress from the diner. You work at Ted's Diner.
Yes, I work at Ted's Diner.
Ted's Diner? You work at Ted's Diner?
Yes.
Then you work for me.
Oh no, I don't work for you. I work for Ted.
I'm Theodore Higginsworth III. I'm Ted.
You're Ted?
Yes, and I was on my way to Bethlehem to close my diner.
Oh, your Ted? God bless you. God bless you. Lots of folk who eat Christmas Eve dinner at Ted's diner wouldn't even have a meal at all if it weren't for you. Oh, God bless you, Mr. Ted. You're the best.
Well, Mr.
Higginsworth is trying to say is that he is overcome by a gratitude that he thanks. He has loved serving those who are hungry on Christmas Eve with all the extra food left over. Right?
Well, I didn't know.
Well, what do you know? It looks like everyone is making new friends. Just wanted to say we might be here for a bit.
Oh no. Mrs. Davis, will we miss our rehearsal?
I'm afraid we might, Abby.
Mrs. Davis, I have an idea. Let's rehearse now.
Yes, let's rehearse now.
Well, I guess we're going to rehearse the nativity.
But we don't have our angels or the wise men.
I could be an angel.
Could I be a wise man?
Sure.
You know, I'd love to be a wise man.
But we need one more.
Oh, no, don't look at me. I've had enough guidance for one night.
I'll be a wise woman.
Mr. Higginsworth, I think you're gonna like this.
Firstborn, a son. She wrapped him in cloth and placed him in a manger, because there's no room for them in the inn.
And there were shepherds living out in the fields nearby, keeping watch over their flocks at night.
And suddenly, an angel of the Lord appeared to them, and they were terrified.
And the angel said to them, "Fear not, for I bring you good news of great joy that will be for all people.
Today, in the town of David, a Savior has been born.
He is Christ the Lord."
Did you like the nativity, Mr. Higginsworth?
Yes, I did, Ava, very much. I guess I never really paid attention to that story.
Christmas is the story of Jesus.
Yes, I understand that now.
Joy starts with Jesus!
Yes, in your song you sang about, he is the one who gives joy to all.
Christmas is a time of miracles, and I believe one is happening right now.
Ginny.
Yes, sir?
I'm not going to close down the diner. I'm going to make you manager.
Really?
Yes. And maybe you can employ some of your friends.
Yay!
And let's give it a fresh start. Let's call it the Joy Cafe.
Yay!
Mr. Higginsworth, I think you are my Christmas miracle from God.
Yay!
Do you have any idea how much longer we'll be here?
Oh, we're ready to go now. Mission accomplished.
Yay!
Okay, everyone. Next stop, Bethlehem, Pennsylvania.
Yay!
Let's do it. And thanks for being a great sister.
And thanks for being a great brother, Jeremy. Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas, Caitlin. Thank you.
Please join me in singing. Silent night, holy night, all is calm, all is bright, round yon virgin mother child.
Let's pray. Father, what a beautiful sound to think back 2,000 years ago, the night when the angels declared, "For unto you a child is born in the city of David, a Savior, which is Christ the Lord." I thank you for these boys and girls and for going to a school where we can actually celebrate the reason for the season, a school where we can remember that 2,000 years ago you broke forth into the world in the person of Jesus. Lord, I thank you for a school that just had so many boys and girls singing the true meaning of Christmas, that the baby didn't stay in the manger, but eventually lived the life we could never live, died on the cross, and offers hope and eternal life for all those who believe. Thank you for Mrs. Blatz and for Mrs. White. Thank you for all the teachers and administrators. And thank you for all these parents and grandparents represented here and the families, the covenant community of God, celebrating that Jesus has come into the world. And it's in his name I pray. Amen.
Let's give the students a round of applause. I hope that this brought you joy this morning and helped you to refocus yourself, getting away from the gift wrap and the Christmas cards and all the busyness of the season, to just stop and remember that beautiful baby born so long ago. The children are being taken across the street for dismissal. You have a wristband to get you in past security. Please hold here until we get the children out of the building. We would prefer you do not give your teacher a heart attack for Christmas by taking your child and she gets to the room and goes, "Where's Johnny?" So, Mrs. White, if you could come forward, Mrs. Blatz, if you could come forward, our student council president and vice president have a little something for you.
Thank you, Miss White, for teaching all the actors their lines.
Thank you, Ms. Blatz, for choreographing everything for the Christmas program.
Let's give Mrs. White and Mrs. Blatz a big thank you for all the effort they put into this beautiful program. Have a wonderful Christmas. Thank you for coming. Enjoy your break, and we'll see you back in January.